Measles was a common childhood disease in the United States until it was considered eliminated in the year 2000, and that's because the vaccine is so effective and durable. Vaccine was introduced in 1963, and we saw cases come down. And more recently, they added a second dose of the vaccine in the 1990s. And then in 2000, it was considered eliminated, but we're always at risk of losing that status if we start to see transmission of measles cases again. And that would largely come if we don't get enough people vaccinated. We are worried about measles because it's one of the more transmissible viral pathogens out there. It's kind of our example of a very transmissible pathogen. And we know that there are some people that can't get vaccinated or are unlikely to respond to the vaccine. And so we don't want it to get a foothold where it can start to transmit in anybody that might not respond or is unvaccinated. About 30% of people that get measles will develop complications. The most common one is diarrhea, but other causes that you can see in children, they can get otitis media or ear infections. Measles virus itself can cause pneumonia. And then about 1 in 1,000 people with measles infection can actually have measles virus infect their brain and spinal cord and cause encephalitis, which can cause significant problems, including coma and death. Measles is transmitted through tiny little airborne droplets. And it can actually linger in those droplets for up to 2 hours after an infected person has left the room. So that's one of the concerns we have with measles. The other concern is that 90% of susceptible people, that means people that are unvaccinated, that are exposed to measles, can become infected. So it has a very high transmission rate. After somebody's exposed to measles, it generally takes about 1 to 2 weeks before they start to exhibit the signs of measles infection. It can go all the way out to 3 weeks, but most people it's 1 to 2 weeks. People are considered contagious with measles from about 4 days before they develop the characteristic rash and about 4 days after that time period. The initial symptoms that people have with measles infection are cough, this runny nose, and then these itchy, watery eyes, which if you think about it, are very consistent with a lot of upper respiratory infections that are transmitting right now. After about 2 to 4 days of those symptoms, that's when people develop this characteristic rash. Starts off in the face, usually around the hairline, and then moves down to the rest of the body, to the trunk, to the arms and the legs. It tends to be these flat red-brown dots. Sometimes they can be bumpy as well. They are not blisters that you see with chicken pox. So they're these flat spots that can sometimes merge together. And that lasts for about a week before it starts to fade. And it starts to fade in the order that it presents from the head down. The most common symptoms that people have with measles, initially they have this cough, this runny nose, and these itchy, watery eyes. After that is when they develop the characteristic rash, which again starts around the hairline on the face and then moves down to the body, arms, and legs. Those are the most common symptoms. The most common complication is diarrhea, and that happens in about 8% of people with measles. So diarrhea can be another symptom people see. So the most important thing that someone should not do if they have signs and symptoms of measles is to go out in public spaces. Don't go to work. Don't go to school. It's highly transmissible to other people. You should call your healthcare provider. If you need to be seen, you need to talk with them and communicate so that they know to put a mask on you and take you into a private room, dedicated room, so you can be in the appropriate isolation precautions to reduce that risk of transmission to other people. The measles virus is fortunately readily killed by standard disinfectants. It's also killed by good hand hygiene with soap and water, or alcohol-based hand rub is even better. It's easier to carry around. Those things will all kill the measles virus. There are a number of things that can cause fever and rash, particularly in children, that can be confused with measles. One thing that can be confused with measles is chickenpox. That rash looks different. It has little vesicles or fluid-filled blister-looking lesions versus the flat brown lesions that you typically see with measles. In young children, infants, particularly around that 9-month age period, they can get erythema infantum, which is a rash that's caused by a different virus called HHV6. It's not transmissible like measles virus. Drug eruptions or reactions to drugs can cause a rash and fever that can look similar to measles. Syphilis can also cause fever and rash, so there are a number of other things that can cause fever and rash. Measles will eventually go away because of your immune system responding to it and creating antibodies to help clear it out. That's also why immunocompromised people are at higher risk for serious complications, because they may not have that ability to generate those antibodies. It's also why it's so important to get the vaccine so that you already have those antibodies on board to help prevent infection, or if you get infection, to make sure it blunt the severity of that illness. Really, we get most of that data from looking in the United States when measles circulated quite a bit more. So again, year-to-year basis, about 3 million cases of measles, about 500 deaths. So the case fatality rate isn't high, but in an avoidable disease, a vaccine-preventable disease, any death is really too much. One of the reasons that we're concerned about measles virus in anywhere in the United States is that young children are at higher risk for some of the complications, and particularly things like encephalitis. There's also a condition called subacute sclerosing panencephalitis, which is really rare with measles, but it happens particularly in kids that are less than 2 years of age. Basically, what this is that 7 to 10 years after you had your measles virus infection, you develop this progressive neurologic disease that leads to death. So it doesn't happen very frequently, but it can happen, and it's one of the reasons we don't want to see recurrence or resurgence of measles virus infections in the United States.